I have Visual Studio Code sitting here with some environmental variables that I want to pass into the commands that I'm going to run to create an Azure container instance service. So if we just take a quick look in the Azure web portal, I don't have anything created here, and I'm actually going to go through the steps of even creating the storage account, although you could reuse a storage account if you have one available. So these commands I'm about to run are to create an Azure container instance with running Buddybase with persistent storage for the slash home directory, which will store the data for CouchDB and Mineo. So the first I want to do it running the AZ command line tools here. You can do the same thing in the UI if you wish, but first thing I'm going to do is set these environment variables for the resource group name that I want to use. So this already exists, and this is a storage account that I'm going to create for this just for this demo. I'm going to create it in Western Europe, and I'm going to call the actual SIF share that's going to store the persistent data is going to be called My Buddybase. So if I run the first command, which is to create the storage account, and if we just check, then we can go under storage accounts and check that that one exists. I've noticed that I've had to refresh a few times just to see things. And we can see here now in storage accounts, it has created this storage account for us. The next step is to create a share within that storage account. So there's no file shares here at the minute. I'm going to use this command here to do so. Give that a few seconds, and that will create the SIFS share, which can be mounted into the Linux container. Once I've created that share, I'll need to retrieve the key f for that share that I can use then when I'm creating the container. So I'll just make sure that I have got a key in that variable. Yeah, I've got a key there. So that's the key that I'm going to want to use in this final command that runs the container. I'll just pop back over here to file shares and make sure that we've got something showing up. Yep, we've got My Buddybase share, which is in there, and that's the share that we're going to mount into the container service. So if I then run this command to create the share, you'd notice that I'm mounting the volume that we've just created under slash home, and I'm using the Buddybase AIS image. Although the other, the normal image may work, I'm going to have to test that later without hyphen AIS here. But you would have to mount slash data here. So I'll try that in a different video, maybe. So I'm going to run that to create the container. Probably just pause here for a few seconds. So after a little while, the command for creating the container echoes out the JSON to describe the container instances. And back in the UI, we can visit the container instances tab here and see that we've got the My Buddybase service running. You can see details of individual containers under this containers menu item, although we've only got one single container image that's providing the service. You can check the logs of the service under logs. Looks okay. And we can use connect to execute into the container. So if we execute into the container, the first thing we might want to run is the health check. Make sure everything, if that comes back empty, that's good. We can also check the mount is there. If we were to grep for home, we can see that's there. And if we visit slash home, we can see that we've got our .env file, our folders for Couch, Mineo, and search. You'll notice that the reason why this works, so this is less than ideal using SIFS as the file system backend for this, because you don't get the normal Linux file permissions and ownership. But because it's mounted by default to be read, write, and execute for everyone, so the storage still works for that reason. So it still works, and it will still be there when we restart the container if I go off and try doing things like that. Although I'll pause each time I do something just to make the video a little bit shorter. So if I was to go back in here, I'll stop the container and then start it again and see if it gets a new IP address. And if I start this container again, the service should start. It may take a few minutes to get up and running, and we can check for an IP address once that's complete. So I successfully restarted the container, and after a few minutes it gets running again, and it shows up with a new IP address here. When I load up the IP address, I can see the welcome screen for Buddybase, and the same with the DNS name that is created for your container. So I could set myself then up as the main admin user. Once I'm signed into Buddybase, I can create an app. I'm going to use the template for the job application tracker so that I can test the uploading of attachments. With that application created, I can publish it and visit the app's address. So in this job tracker application, I'm going to visit each or some of the users here and just upload some files that I've got prepared here. So there's a fake CV saved in under Joe Johnson. Let's see, Louise Rogers. We'll just put in an image. So there's some fiber optics there. We'll save that. And let's see who else is here. Andrew Wingman. I'll just drop a text file in for this one. So that's three items saved here. If we go back to Azure and visit the containers and connect to the container, execute in. If we visit slash home, let's have a look under the Minio folder and under prod, and this is the app ID, and in here there should be an attachments folder, and we can see here that we've got directories for each of the attachments that we just uploaded: a text, a JPEG, and a PDF. So let's what I want to do next is to stop this container completely, then recreate the container but with the same storage backend. So the IP address will obviously change from this 52 address, but the DNS name should stay the same, and we should get back to our fully working application. So let me go into the container here. I'm going to stop it first, and then I'm going to delete. So we don't have any container instances running anymore. So what I'm going to do is go back to my command line here and just recreate the container with exactly the same command, this one here. And I'm saying again to for the storage that I've already created, just to mount that under slash home, which should get us back to a fully working container. So this will take a few minutes for this to recreate the container instances. So I'll pause for a little bit. So after a few minutes, the container service was recreated again, and we can see here the details. The IP address has changed. If you can see that it used to be 52.245, and it is now 20.101.232.209. So I'm going to copy that IP address, and visit data could use the DNS name as well, but for the speed of this video I'm using IP addresses in case of any DNS caching going on. So I log in with the login that I created earlier on the previous container, but because we have persistent storage, this should allow me to log in. And I'm back, and I can see my job application tracker app still in here. And if I check the details of the applications, I should see the attachments that I added earlier. So we can see here that we've got the image attached to Louise Rogers' application, the PDF that I attached to Joe's application, and a text file that I attached to Andrew's application. So everything's the persistent, the storage is still persisted across the creation of a new container. So that answers a few of the issues we may want if we want to try to run Buddybase in Azure. So to summarize what we've been looking at, we are able to persist our storage across container restarts in the Azure Container Instances Service, ACI. The storage we use to persist the data uses SIFS as the file share type, as opposed to NFS, which Azure doesn't yet support NFS. And we're able to browse those files in the Azure portal. So if I was to drill down into the file share that we've got here, My Buddybase, we can see the folders and files here we could connect and use those, copy them elsewhere if I need to. So the outstanding issue really is about certificates and using our own custom domain with the service. So as you can see in the service, we have a DNS name for the service, and we could just point a CNAME from our own domain at that address if we wanted to, or we could set up Cloudflare to front the service and then point to this address, or we could use load balancers or application gateways in Azure to sort of load balance and provide certificates and our own custom domains. But that's a topic for another day. Hopefully this is enough to get your containers, your Buddybase containers, running in Azure.